Hello everybody, Lurgs here. Welcome to my channel. I'm here to save you time and money. And today it's how to use WhatsApp on your computer desktop. If you've got WhatsApp on your iPhone, it's really, really simple to just transfer it straight across to your big screen and use it on there. Right, let's get cracking.
Just gonna have a quick cup of tea before we get started. Take your iPhone and then go into the WhatsApp app. You can see here I'm on my chat. So what you want to do is down in the bottom right hand corner, you've got this settings icon. So just select the settings. Then you want to select WhatsApp web/desktop. What that does, that activates your camera waiting for a QR code. What you need to do now is on your computer or laptop, open up a web browser. I'm just going to open up Google Chrome and then type in web.whatsapp.com. This will then sit on a web page with a QR code waiting to be scanned by your phone. Now you'll notice here you've got this keep me signed in tick box. I'll come to this later on, but I don't want to be kept signed in, so I'm going to keep it unchecked. Now go back to your iPhone and it's waiting to scan the QR code. So I'm just going to move it across very slowly so you can see how it works. And as soon as it picks up the QR code, then boom time! We are in WhatsApp on the computer. Now this is absolutely identical to what you're seeing on your iPhone. So what you can basically do is you can do anything that you can do on your iPhone. So you can read messages, you can send messages, you can play videos. I'm just going to play this video clip here just very quickly.
Hey, peekaboo.
And there's a link above now about how to clear your WhatsApp chats to save lots of space on your iPhone. I'm just going to go to one of my contacts here, Ash, and just type in a quick message. Anything that you do on the WhatsApp website will be replicated on your iPhone. That message that I've just sent and the new one that's just come through is on my iPhone here. Now, if I type a reply on my iPhone, likewise, if I then go back to the website, you can see it just pops up there. Now, earlier on, I explained about the checkbox where you want to keep yourself signed in, and I didn't do that. But if you did, what can happen is if you close down the website, when you come back in, it will just remember exactly where you were. Now, you don't probably want this because if your partner's a bit of a spy, they might go onto your WhatsApp and start checking all your messages. So I always make sure that I keep that checkbox unticked, or definitely when you've finished on your website on the WhatsApp, just click on log out. I'm back on my iPhone here. If you go to settings and WhatsApp web/desktop, it shows you when you were last active today on Windows, and you can log out from all devices from here.
If you found that video useful, please subscribe by pressing this button down here so you don't miss more videos on how to save you time and money. There's also some other videos around the edges of the screen here. If any of those are useful to you, then you can select those now. Thank you for visiting my channel, everyone. I really, really appreciate it.